Welcome to the video, How to Get More Savings from Ductless Heat Pumps. This content was originally delivered as a webinar in the fall of 2020. This video has been produced by the Northwest Ductless Heat Pump Project, which is a program of the Northwest Energy Efficiency Alliance. NEA, as it is called, is an alliance of more than 140 Northwest utilities and energy efficiency organizations working on behalf of more than 13 million energy consumers. NEA operates the Northwest Ductless Heat Pump Project for their member utilities and their trade ally contractors, providing training, research, technical support, manufacturer promotions, and program evaluation. The content you are about to see has been designed for contractors who are interested in installing ductless heat pumps, specifically how they work to save electricity today and how they can work to better save electricity in the future. We will cover some important strategies contractors can employ to help customers and utilities get the most with their energy rebate investments. The information covered in this video comes from new research. In 2018, NEA initiated the Maximizing Mini-Split Performance Research Project. The key points in this video come from the findings of this extensive research project. The information you are about to see is the result of tests done at the Pacific Northwest National Laboratory, interviews with experts and utility programs managers, and a variety of recent research studies. To see the complete research report, go to the URL shown on this screen. My name is Jonathan Moscatello. I'm a consultant and I began working on the Northwest Ductless Heat Pump Project in 2018. The majority of my experience is in the HVAC industry, specifically with ductless heat pumps, including marketing, sales, and installation. My wife owns and operates a ductless-only contracting business that has been around since 2007, and some of our lessons learned will be reflected in this video. Before I dive into the findings of the Maximizing Mini-Split Research Project, I think it is worth creating some context around how rebates work generally, and specifically how the ductless heat pump rebate program is designed to produce energy savings. Let's begin by discussing how utility energy efficiency rebates are tied to energy savings. The amount of energy savings a given product delivers determines the size or amount of a rebate. If research can prove that the amount of savings is significant, a utility will be allowed to offer a significant rebate. If not, no rebate will be allowed. Most utility rebate programs are funded by money that comes from ratepayers, and regulators oversee energy efficiency rebate programs to ensure that that money is being used in a manner consistent with the law. In general, these laws and regulations operate under a simple test. Does the energy saved by a rebated product cost less than if a utility were to go and generate new power or purchase that power on the open market? While rebates have been shown to greatly influence consumer behaviors and energy savings, it's important to understand that a tremendous amount of research is involved. Specifically, before a rebate can be issued, a utility has to prove how much energy can be saved and what the cost of that savings is. And each year or so, the utility has to evaluate the installations to prove that the savings are actually occurring, both at the expected amounts and for the expected costs. Think about all of the energy efficiency rebates that are available today, and you can imagine that a lot of research and evaluation is required. When rebated products are saving energy in the amounts expected and for the cost to install that was expected, rebate programs work beautifully. Let's look specifically at ductless heat pump rebates. Unfortunately, ductless heat pump rebates are at risk for many utilities because evaluation research shows that the energy saved by installing a new ductless heat pump too often costs more than the open market price of that energy. In other words, the basic regulator's test is not being passed. You might be wondering, what can be done to save ductless rebates? Thinking back to the basic regulator's test, which states that the energy saved by a ductless heat pump must be lower cost than the market price of that power, we could do two things. First, we could lower the installed cost of a ductless heat pump. Or we could take steps to ensure that rebated ductless heat pump installations save more energy than they currently do. Now, I live with a contractor, and in fact, all the contractors I know need more margin from the ductless heat pumps they install, not less. And for a variety of reasons we discuss in this video, there are much easier and more immediate things that contractors can do to save ductless rebates. Before we jump into the four things that can be done to get more energy savings out of ductless heat pumps, let's quickly review how the ductless rebate program is designed to get energy savings in the first place. At the Northwest Ductless Heat Pump Project, we support the displacement of electric resistance heat in homes by installing a ductless heat pump. This includes baseboard heaters, wall heaters, electric forced air furnaces, and more. We use a ductless heat pump because electric resistance heat is 2 to 3 times more expensive to operate when compared to a properly installed and applied ductless heat pump. The key to success in making displacement of electric resistance heat with a ductless heat pump work best is found in the following steps. In step one, we identify the room or rooms in the home where the occupants spend most of their time. The ductless heat pump is installed in this main living area. Ideally, this is the living room or family room. The ductless heat pump is sized to take over the entire heating requirement of this main living area. In step two, we plan to keep the electric resistance heat in the other rooms of the home and plan for their continued use as backup or supplemental heat. In step three, we teach the homeowner how to use their electric resistance heat only when they feel they need to, and we instruct them on the proper use and maintenance of their ductless heat pump. When all three steps are performed properly, the results are nothing short of amazing. Homeowners can save up to 50% on their heating bills, and when you heat with electric resistance heat, this can be a lot of money. And customers love their ductless heat pumps, with 91% of homeowners surveyed reporting that they are very or extremely happy with their ductless heat pumps. This is the highest end of satisfaction and comparable to some of the most successful and popular consumer products ever sold. For HVAC contractors, there's nothing that we sell that can satisfy customers to this extent. And when our customers are this happy, they tell their friends, family, and neighbors all about it, which generates referrals, and which are very important for the business. Now that we understand the basics about how rebate programs work, and specifically how the ductless heat pump rebate program is intended to work, let's talk about the four ways to get more savings from rebated ductless installations so that we can work to preserve ductless rebates in our market. The number one thing we can do is target homes with big electric resistance heating usage. Unfortunately, in too many cases, ductless rebates are being used in homes where there is too little electricity being used for heating, and you can't save what isn't being used in the first place. Perhaps the homeowner heats with wood or pellets or another source and isn't using their electric heat. Our research shows that if ductless rebates were only used on homes with sizable electric heating loads, the savings in homes with an electric forced air furnace would increase 137%. And if ductless heat pump rebates were only used in homes with sizable loads from electric zonal heat, savings would increase 84%. If you are a contractor watching this video, you are likely thinking, isn't it the utility's responsibility to tell me where these homes are that use a lot of electricity for heating? Certainly the utility has a role to play here, but as a contractor, I encourage you to be proactive. There are privacy rules that utilities have to comply with. And in the meantime, there are a couple of things that you can do, if successfully implemented, that will benefit your in-home sales process. Tip number one involves having a conversation with the homeowner about what they spend on electricity during the winter months. And then compare what they tell you with what they spend on electricity during the summer months. If the difference is $100 or more, there is a lot of potential savings. If the difference is small, like under $50 a month, the savings will be small. There are plenty of reasons to get a ductless heat pump, so if the savings potential is low, don't give up. Next, while still at the home, contact the representative at the utility for energy efficiency rebates. Ask them if they would like to have a rebate application from the customer. Make a show of it and demonstrate to the homeowner that you are willing to advocate for their interests. By doing this, it puts the decision-making solidly in the hands of the utility program, where it belongs. In my experience, the utility program manager will evaluate the energy usage of the home and likely find a way to authorize the rebate. If they choose not to allow the rebate, it's no reflection on you. And because ductless heat pumps are such a desirable home improvement, experience shows that the homeowner will likely proceed without the utility rebate. The number two thing we can do is ensure that installations receiving ductless rebates have their indoor unit installed in the main living area. Research has shown that many electrically heated homes are getting indoor units installed in suboptimal locations. The result of this is the ductless system isn't able to take over enough of the electric heating load of the home. Here we see rooms where homeowners often want a ductless unit installed. I call these secondary rooms or zones. Note, they are not in the main living area and do not conform to the ductless rebate program design. If a homeowner wants to have a ductless system installed in a location other than the living room, this is a great opportunity to let them know they can expect much less savings or possibly no savings at all. If the homeowner wants energy savings and wants comfort in one of those secondary rooms, encourage the homeowner not to sacrifice installing in the main living area, especially if they want to apply for a ductless rebate. If all rebated ductless heat pump installations had their indoor unit installed in the main living area or living room, savings in homes with an electric forced air furnace would increase 12%, and savings in homes with electric zonal heating would increase 18%. In some homes, like the one found in this picture, it can be hard to find a location for the indoor unit, or it can be unclear where best to locate the indoor unit to achieve the greatest savings. The Northwest Ductless Heat Pump Project research shows that the best location is the area with the greatest heat loss. In this way, the ductless system will experience the greatest use while minimizing use of the electric resistance heat to the greatest extent possible. If it isn't clear which area has the greatest heat loss, look for the room with the greatest floor area and/or the greatest amount of window area. The number three thing that can be done to preserve ductless rebates is to use recommended installation practices. By using recommended installation practices, it ensures a rebated ductless system will operate to its full potential and energy efficiency. Research has shown that installation oversights and mistakes are frequent, and they contribute to reduction of system performance, which will ultimately cause greater energy usage. If all ductless heat pump installations strictly followed manufacturer and utility recommended practices, savings in homes with an electric forced air furnace would increase 9%, while savings in homes with electric zonal heating would increase 13%. It's easy to install correctly, and proper installation is the contractor's core responsibility. But there are additional benefits of ensuring use of recommended practices. And these many benefits will impact the long-term success of the contractor's business. such as greater customer satisfaction and reduced rates of warranty. If you want to learn more, the Northwest Ductless Heat Pump Project has created two really helpful resources for installers. Our installer guides detail the recommended installation practices that will help ensure energy savings and system performance. These installer guides are great to use for training installers and managing their quality. They can be found at the project website, goingductless.com. The number four way to increase savings of rebated ductless installations includes educating homeowners on using their ductless system. There are several common user errors that impact ductless energy savings, and these are, number one, homeowners don't know that they can use their ductless system for heating. People can be forgetful. Maybe they purchased their ductless heat pump in the summer, and by the time heating season comes around, they forgot it can be used for heating too. This issue points to an opportunity for a contractor to send an email blast out to homeowners at the start of heating season to remind them that their ductless heat pump can save them lots on their heating bill too. Number two is use of the auto changeover mode. This feature was designed for condos and high-rise buildings with lots of glass and where heating is needed at night, but sunlight can cause overheating during the day. In the Northwest and in single-family homes, this feature simply does not work well. On mild days, ductless heat pumps have been found to ping-pong back and forth between heating and cooling, which uses lots of energy unnecessarily. Number three is use of a setback temperature. Set it and forget it is a saying we use. Now, we have research to show that setback temperatures of more than 3 degrees wind up causing excessive energy use. Unless a homeowner wants to change temperature at night for comfort, it is best to leave it set at a comfortable temperature all heating season. The inverter controls will manage the system to operate efficiently. Number four is unnecessary or improper use of backup heat. This causes the ductless and the electric resistance heating to fight each other. Sometimes people will operate their ductless heat pump in cooling mode without turning off their electric resistance heat. This causes the heating and cooling to operate simultaneously, working against each other, and this can use a lot of power. This is another opportunity to send an email out to homeowners reminding them to shut down their electric furnace or other heaters when cooling season comes around. If all rebated ductless heat pump installations included the homeowner receiving a thorough instruction on how to use their new system, savings in homes with an electric forced air furnace would increase 8%, while savings in homes with electric zonal heating would increase 1.2%. The research made clear that educating the customer on how to use their ductless heat pump is key to producing meaningful energy savings and customer satisfaction. I believe that educating the customer on how to use their new ductless heat pump is part of the bond a contractor has with their customer. I also believe that the responsibility doesn't stop with the customer. The contractor is also responsible to the utility, too. Think of it like this. When a contractor sells a ductless heat pump and helps the homeowner get a rebate for it, the contractor becomes responsible for helping to deliver the heating savings to the utility. In fact, this relationship between the utility and their participating contractor is how energy efficiency rebate programs are designed to work. The Northwest Ductless Heat Pump Project created a great homeowner education flyer. It was created for contractors to use with the homeowner. It has all the topics that you will need to go over with the homeowner, and it is available for download at goingductless.com. In closing, there are four ways to get more savings out of rebated ductless heat pump installations, and implementing them adds little or no additional cost. Clearly, targeting of homes that use a lot of electricity for heating offers the greatest opportunity for savings. However, items 2, 3, and 4 are very easy to do and involve practices that are solidly the responsibility of contractors. Therefore, it is in our best interest to be doing them. And when added together, items 2, 3, and 4 produce meaningful benefit to utilities and homeowners. There is a fifth way to get more savings out of a ductless heat pump that was identified by our research. We did not discuss it today because it is a comprehensive and wide-ranging subject. Our research found that meaningful savings are possible when controls are used to link the operation of a ductless heat pump and the electric resistance heating. The controls are primarily used to lock out the electric resistance heating when the ductless system is in cooling mode. Further savings are gained when the controls are used to operate the ductless system as the primary heating source, and the electric resistance heating in the secondary zones is controlled to come on only when it is needed. Please let your utility know if you are interested in learning more about this research subject and the integrated controls application. Another topic we didn't cover today, but we think is on your mind, has to do with how multi-zone ductless systems affect energy savings and rebate programs. This subject is important, but very complicated. We did not include discussion of multi-zone systems in this video because the many ductless rebate programs in the Northwest already understand the challenges presented by multi-zone systems. In general, multi-zone systems always cost more when compared to a single-zone system, and they do not produce reliable savings. For a rebate program already struggling with high cost relative to the amount of energy saved, multi-zone systems present an unwinnable situation for ductless rebate programs. In today's presentation, we focused on the solutions that contribute to additional savings for little or no cost, because that is the best path forward for ductless rebates in the Northwest. Earlier, we talked about recommended installation practices. To learn more about them, check out the video dedicated to the subject. In this video, we discuss research findings from the Northwest and other cold climate areas on the subject of installation errors and oversights and how they impact ductless heat pump operation. We hope you will check it out. We hope this presentation has given you some great ideas on how to get more savings out of your ductless heat pump installations. If you want to keep learning, check out the great contractor resources and information at goingductless.com or the free load calculation software available at hvacsizingtool.com.